And of course, we're getting into the love section of the show this particular morning. Remember, it usually happens at exactly 10 a.m. Now, someone is writing to us, and of course, the biggest problem here is my fiance's sister has become a menace. Now, they're saying that, hello, Aban, today I have been engaged to my fiance for about 2 years now. We both have a beautiful daughter and have been happy, not until recent when his sister came to stay with us. She has become very possessive of my man. She decides what we eat, what he wears, and also what he should do with his salary at the end of the month. She keeps telling my fiance that I'm his type of woman, that he should have gone with the girl, that I'm not his type of woman, that he should have gone with the girl they told him to marry. Now, worst of all is that my fiance now spends more time with her than he does with me. I'm in a fixture. I honestly don't know how to go about this. Please help.
Lero gwa ba yamba.
First summarize it.
Wow. No, lero ya ba yamba. Ya so gwa soka.
Ati rachi.
Gwa soka. Kwa bintu bino. Gwa ba soka. What is your say?
She has become very possessive of my man.
Uh-huh. Wouldn't you want your sister-in-law to be possessive of you?
No, this situation is...
Okay, just summarize it for Willis. Maybe
Willis, you still want me to summarize for you?
Binji.
Binji. Kati, onatuandi kila gamba.
Asigambe interpret in Uganda.
Ngambi summarize.
Speak English, but summarize.
Summarize. Okay, this is what has happened. You, Willis, have this one.
Ah.
Now, kwa sana example. Roganda kutege la mangu.
Toko isa anzeneda.
Okay.
No,
okay.
Don't use me.
Okay.
Use Tina.
No, I don't want to use Tina.
Use you.
You are the problem
use
here.
Use you.
Okay, fine. Hey. My sister comes to stay with me. And I have a fiancé. We've been together for 2 years.
Okay.
Now, this sister of mine becomes very possessive. He even goes ahead to tell me on how to spend my own salary. She keeps on telling me that the other ex of mine would have been a better wife compared to this one I have now. I'm even spending more time than her compared to the time I spend with my woman. Now, this woman is on writing to us saying, guys, I need your help. Things have become dangerous.
Your sister.
Hey, my sister has become dangerous.
Linda, ko sister-in-law over sister we nini?
No, man, abela sister-in-law fiancé wangi.
Amugobeo.
I'm still
confused.
Okay, now let me use us as an example.
Okay.
You are my woman. You're my fiancé. We've been together for 2 years.
Uh-huh.
Yes? Josephine is
for
my
real
sister.
For
It's an example.
It's an example.
Okay. Okay. Anyway. We need an example. So me and you have been together for 2 years. Josephine is my sister.
Yeah.
So Josephine comes and starts staying with us.
Mm-hmm.
Now, because of Josephine's influence, Josephine keeps on telling me that, you know what? My ex would have been a better woman than
who?
You are.
Just who is your ex?
And all that Mary is my ex.
Which Mary?
Mary. I'm just using random names.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just using random names. Mm. To that extent, Josephine tells me, gwe, kagude yo ako October.
So basically,
I am at work. Josephine is telling you, no, today we have to eat chicken. Tomorrow we are eating ginut. The other day we are eating this.
Let us first ask here in context.
To make matters worse, apparently I spend more time with Josephine, my sister, compared to you.
There are some key questions here that we are going to ask. Question number one.
Yes.
How long has it been between these two siblings not seeing each other or living together?
It doesn't matter.
Wait,
they've not disclosed
wait,
that.
Wait, okay. Number two, is she your elder sister or is she a follower?
That is also something that has not been disclosed.
Thank you. Number three, are you that deprived as a man that, you know when it's your mother-in-law, we understand, yeah, kuzara. Baja mu makanga fe nebetali, mba nebetali.
Nebachankalanya.
Letu waba manjira, kubaba mara nebakowa.
Baja mu makanga mutabani wa.
Exactly. Na yate, awo edikenzo ya jiro obuzibu. Kubanga, nebaja mu makanga mutabani we. Siye ya muwasa, ya wasanze.
Edikenzo tusoke tumveko.
Chitegele.
Tukomeoku unsonga.
So, webuze, ono msajja ina deprivation chi emotionally, emuleka, not even his mom, but his sister, to come into his home, his marital home, and start giving orders. And not just give orders, but also go with them. For me here, I'm reading a disconnect already. There is a major disconnect between the husband and the wife. And the sister knows it, so she's prying on it. That's why she feels she can speak on it. Mm. Because kankubulire no yingira mu makago omukazi who knows enyumba ye. Who knows how she runs a house? Kale ne bwokola otya kuzukusa kumacha na kugamba ebyo oba obyagala gende wabaze wo.
What if this relationship is not moving in the direction that this guy wants it
to move? That's what I'm trying to say.
And he's using the sister as a scapegoat.
Pass!
To just come through and disorganize. Because they're not married. They've just been together for 2 years. This is a fiancé. So literally, bachelor movie.
And you know some families actually do that ish where they're like, let's...
What if there's that possibility?
Agenda soka
Ajira atankalanya.
For me, I think that one, relationships is, you know, in the relationship like this for starters, if you're married to someone, it does not mean that you've become, you're joined, your body is joined, so you can't be separated.
Mm. To become one, they also say it
no,
in church.
No, to become one mumoyo. But listen,
no.
when you're in a relationship with someone, whether marriage or girlfriend or fiancé or whatever, you have to think independently. You have to have an independent mind.
Mm-hmm.
Someone's opinion about your relationship is none of your business. Like if someone tells my wife that... I'm not good for her. That's his opinion. He's entitled
about you and
to his
entitled.
Opinion. You understand? So, her sister-in-law is entitled. Sister Wange Avera entitled to her opinion. If her opinion is she doesn't like you and she feels the Gundi was better, that's her opinion. Tochireka kulia mutwe. Embo joino kusaka amani yeno jivaga amba. The man is the one who's supposed to concentrate on
you. Thank you.
So your sister said that your ex is better. Do you believe that? Because that now matters. His opinion about that fact matters. The sister's opinion to chukuru mia mutwe. Wabu yomo aloza and they have to feel the way they feel.
Okay.
Hainzo kubata kwa agara because you want to amblo vere ya wefu gafu gempeo. Muli mkuli ya wefu gempeo. Hainzo kwa agara. Wachitegira. So her opinion about your relationship is none of your business, but how your fiancé takes it, that should worry
you. So Chogambo Mchala should make a step forward.
Yeah, she should ask this guy.
In
and
the
be
direction
like, okay, fine.
Of the guy.
Yeah, your sister does not like me. I get it. That's her opinion. But you, do you believe she's right? Do you think your ex is better for you than me? That answer is what should inform her decision.
Wagambila, yes?
Yes. Echokubiri. Echokubiri, people need to understand that your home is like your kennel.
It's your sanctuary. It's
no
your
one
heaven.
At any one time
should take that
piece
your away.
Mother or father should ever rob happiness from your home.
Thank you.
You need to protect it above everything else.
Mm-hmm.
And as a man in the home, your job is to make sure everyone in the home is happy.
Okay.
Peace.
You understand? If someone is not
peace
happy,
peace be still.
Yeah, but
even,
in your home
but
as
even
a man,
Jesus could not make everyone happy when he was on earth.
That
how?
Was his. That
how
was
you,
his
how
time.
How? You as a human being, you're going to make
he
him
did.
Happy.
He
was
did.
A happy man.
No happiness. But now happiness, mujifuna movie. Happiness, sikuwela.
It's a state of mind, emotion.
Uso roku yomba nenga muli happy.
King Pharaoh was not happy with Jesus.
Oh, me I. But
listen. Jagalo soko kuteko kakoma. What are you going to do at this point in time? Now inga tona bako chako. Gena gamba. Our studio lines are going to be open. The number to call is on your screen. 0414-337-872. In case you're out there and you've gone through this kind of situation, or even you have some advice that you would give to this lady writing to us, please, we'll ask you to give us a call and let us know what should be the way forward immediately after this.